shoo at the door. Sitting in the middle of the forest was a number of tiny run-down looking huts, some as small as tree houses. These were the remains of what once had been a thriving village. Famine and disease had caused most of its occupants to flee to other parts of the forest. Now, all the huts but one were deserted. This became the home of a witch, her husband, and their 8 children. Now, you might wonder how could such a large number of people live in such a tiny house. It seems that as each child was born, the witch would make the interior of her hut bigger and bigger, using magic. Eventually, the inside became as spacious as a castle. And like a castle, it sported many rooms and secret passageways for her children to explore. But then one day, the oldest child said to his parents that he wanted to leave their home and go out into the world. Even though the witch was sad at the thought of losing her son, she gave him her blessings. Then eventually, as each child grew to adulthood, they too decided they wanted to leave home and see the world. After the last child left, the witch's husband suggested to her that maybe she might want to reduce the size of their hut. There is no need any longer to have all these rooms and corridors. Agreeing, she used her magic to remove all but 2 rooms. For the next several years, the witch and her husband lived alone but comfortably in their tiny hut, until one day, when one of her spells backfired, it ended up killing her and destroying one of the 2 rooms. Saddened by the death of his wife, her husband, who was a male witch, conjured up 8 pairs of shoes, similar to the ones his children used to wear. He lined them up neatly side by side near the front door. Why did he do this, you wonder? He did it so that if any of his children should ever happen to pass by, even though he might not be around any longer, they would recognize the line of shoes and know which hut had once been their home.